curiosity is an innate human quality. We're born with it. There's a lot of things we do in today's society that kind of turn it off in young people, but we're born with it. When did we go from asking questions being a really good, healthy, innocent kind of thing to being offensive? Right? And so you will do yourselves and the people you live and work with a lot of good if when people are asking questions, you just take down the shields. You just refuse to get defensive. You refuse to feel like you're being challenged. You say to yourself, you know what? I'm probably misunderstanding them. They're just curious. They want to know why I did that. They're not challenging me, because you know what? That's usually the case. Collecting dots is hard. Connecting dots, I actually find to be the easy part. You give me the information, and I will figure out what to do with it. I may get it wrong, but I'm going to figure something out. As we saw, our brain's going to help us figure something out. And connecting dots is what we all tend to do when we're problem solving. We take the information we have, and we brainstorm. We come up with ideas. We come up with solutions to problems. It's kind of fun, energetic. I get a check in the box when I come up with an answer, whether it's right or wrong. Collecting dots is hard. It takes time. And you don't get a check in the box for it, not with your traditional to-do list. In fact, where does the idea generation come from? It doesn't usually come from a bunch of people sitting around and brainstorming, saying we have to come up with new ideas. It comes from people putting lots and lots of information into their heads, and the brain does most of the work. The brain is what finds the patterns in that information. The brain, every night when you go to sleep, is what's really generating the new ideas. But you can't generate new ideas, you can't connect the dots in new and different and unique ways if you haven't first collected the dots. Reading is the most important way of doing that, right? Essentially, isn't what you sell to your company use of your brain, or you rent to your company use of your brain, right? You're saying, I have a brain, it's filled with a process, it's filled with knowledge, it's filled with insights, and I'm gonna rent it to you for 8 or 10 hours a day. So Usain Bolt thinks he can get faster. Do you think you can get smarter? And more importantly, do you have any obligation to your company who's paying for the use of your brain? Do you have any obligation to get smarter? You expect continuous improvement and everything else that the company does. Is it fair for the company to expect that your brain is continuously improving?